Morning class, we will start our next topic in ratio and proportion, that is proportion. Children, when four quantities are so related that the ratio between the first and the second quantities is equal to the ratio between the third and the fourth quantities, the quantities are said to be in proportion. Or in short, you can say that it is equality of two ratios. In order to represent a proportion, children, either put the sign of equality between the two ratios or put a double colon. Okay. Consider four quantities, for example, 15, 20, 9 and 12. The ratio between the first and second quantities, that is first two quantities, 15 and 20, and then the ratio between the third and fourth quantities, that is 9 and 12. If these two ratios are equal, then we can say that these four quantities are in proportion. Now children, let's know some facts about it. That each quantity in proportion is called its term or its proportional. First and last terms are called extremes. First and last terms are called extremes, whereas the second and third terms are called means. Okay, second and third are called means. For every proportion, children, the product of extremes is always equal to the product of the means. Okay. And last thing, the fourth term is called the fourth proportion. Now, one more thing is there, children, in this. That is continued proportion. Three quantities are said to be in continued proportion if the ratio between the first and the second quantities is equal to the ratio between the second and the third quantities. In short, you can say that let A, B, C are in continued proportion when if A is to B is equal to B is to C, or you can say that B square is equal to AC. When B is mean proportion between A and C, it implies that A, B and C are in continued proportion if B square is equal to AC. Okay, now let us do the exercise, children. Exercise 6B. Check whether the following quantities form a proportion or not. So I have done question number 1, first part for all of you. 3x, 7x, 24 and 56. So first two quantities, the ratio of the first two quantities and the ratio of the last two quantities. Now 3x upon 7x is equal to 3 upon 7 and 24 upon 56 is equal to 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, 2 2s are 4, 2 are 16, then 2 6s are 12, 2 7s are 14. It is also again coming 3 is to 7. So yes, the given four quantities are in proportion. One more part I have done for you here is 0.4, 0.5, 2.9 and 3.5. So now let's again check the ratio of the first two quantities. 0.4 is to 0.5. 0.4 upon 0.5. It is giving us 4 upon 5. This decimal, remove this decimal and we get 4 is to 5. Then 2.9 is to 3.5. Again, this decimal, remove this decimal. It is giving 29 upon 35. So you can see that they are different. They are not equal. No, the given four quantities are not in proportion. Now let's do question number 2, children. Find the fourth proportional of 5, 9 and 45. 1, 2 and 3 terms they have given and he is asking the fourth one. So let the fourth proportional be x. It implies that 5 is 9, 45 and x are in proportion. Therefore, when they are in proportion, the ratio of the first two quantities is equal to the ratio of the last two quantities. So 5 upon 9 is equal to 45 upon x. And then you can cross multiply. 5 into x is equal to 45 into 9, and this 5 will come in the denominator. 5 9s are 45 and 9 9s are 81. Answer. One more part I have done for you here is this. 1 upon 3, 2 upon 5 and 8.4. Again we have to find the fourth proportional. Let the fourth proportional be x. So we'll write, this implies that n x are in proportion. And when they are in proportion, again the same thing. The ratio of the first and second quantity is equal to the ratio of the third and the fourth quantities. So remove this ratio sign, divide, and when you remove the divide sign, you'll put a multiply and reciprocal this term. So 5 upon 2, and it is going as it is, 8.4 upon x, 8.4 upon x till here, and then cross multiply 5 into x and 6 into 8.4. then this 5 will go down, and I have divided the 6 by 5, it has come 1.2. now multiply these two terms and you'll get 10.08. next question come is, find the third proportional of. Now here two quantities are given and he's telling us to find the third proportion. So let the third proportional be x. So 1.8, 0.6 and x are in continued proportion. Therefore, 1.8 is to 0.6 equal to 0.6 is to x. Now we'll write this 0.6 two times, at the place of second quantity also, at the place of third quantity also. Then again the same procedure, cross multiply. 1.8 into x is equal to 0.6 into 0.6. And then this 1.8 will come in the denominator, and then the calculation part you will do yourself. Now question number 4 I'll explain in my next video, children. Please do the work till here. Thank you. Have a nice day.